Hi, this is Larry Jordan. The following is an excerpt of a power-up webinar looking at integrating Motion 5.1 with Final Cut Pro 10. In this excerpt, I'll show you how to take an existing Motion project and convert it so you can play it inside Final Cut Pro 10. We've seen that we can modify existing effects by moving them from Final Cut to Motion. But what happens if I have an existing Motion project that I want to bring across to Final Cut? Well, for instance, here I'm going to just select a Motion project, click Open, and let's pick something from the library. One of my favorite sections is called Content, and backgrounds are animated full-screen backgrounds. I want to find a background called Morning, so click the magnifying glass and type the word Morning, and it does a search for all the backgrounds that are inside that selected folder that have the word Morning in the title. Highlight it and click Apply. Shift-Z to get this to fit, and we'll again hide the timeline index. Press the F6 key so that disappears. If I hit the spacebar or just skim across here, we've got the look of sunlight radiating through the clouds, and it's very lovely. Let us pretend that it's not a simple background. Let's pretend that this is a football scoreboard that we created 4 years ago in Motion 3, and we want to be able to use this scoreboard and change the text inside Final Cut. I've got animated Who's-Its up here and animated text and color and styling. It's got all kinds of really great stuff in it, except if I save this as, we'll call this a scoreboard. Save it to the desktop just to put it somewhere. And now switch over to Final Cut and go up to Command-I, File, Import, and go to the desktop by clicking the favorites that says Desktop. There's the scoreboard, and I can't bring it in. Final Cut 10 does not read Motion projects unless, when we go back to Motion, unless I go up to the Share menu, go down to Export Movie, and inside Export Movie, I then have to save it as Apple ProRes 4x4, include the alpha channel of the video. I mean, okay, this will work. The best reason for using Export is I want to take this Motion project and move it to Premiere or to Avid, or I want to move it to Final Cut 7. I want the transparency, the alpha channel, to be retained. Then exporting as a QuickTime movie is a perfect solution. Works great everywhere. It just takes a while, and the file sizes are quite big. Instead, I want to just move this Motion project. Remember, it could be any Motion project that I can open in Motion 5. Go up to the File menu and say Publish Template. What this does is it converts it to a template which can be read inside Final Cut. So let's call this scoreboard template. Now it's not really a scoreboard, but we'll give that feeling, pretend it is. And it's going to be published as a Final Cut generator. That is the critical checkbox. If you also want to include a preview movie, check Save Preview Movie. This allows you to see the animation when you skim your mouse across it inside Final Cut. Normally, I would check this, but it takes about 10 to 15 seconds to create the preview movie, and I don't want to waste the time today. So for this demo, I am not checking Save Preview Movie. In real life, I always check Save Preview Movie. So I check the bottom two, but the one that's critical is Publish as Final Cut Generator. Then we say, well, what category do we want this in? I'm going to create a category called Larry. Now, you don't have to create a category called Larry. It could be called Susan or Eric or Fred, whatever you want. You could have it be named after a client. There's no limit to the number of categories you create. But at least I can remember Larry. We'll create Larry, and we're going to call this a full screen background, which is a theme that I created for the earlier show, and click Publish. The beep says that it's done. Switch over to Final Cut, and now go to the Generator menu, and notice there's a new category called Larry, and there is our scoreboard. If I grab this and simply drag it down to the timeline, there is our animated effect. Now, it doesn't show up immediately because it hasn't been rendered yet. So I'm going to select this, go up to the Modify menu, and say Render Selection. There it is. This has been an excerpt of a recent power-up webinar looking at the integration between Motion 5.1 and Final Cut Pro 10. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store and look for Webinar 118. By the way, if you need to stretch your training dollars, a subscription membership to our video training library saves you money. You can access all of our videos for a low monthly price of only $19.99. That's more than 700 movies, dozens of hours of training, all in-depth and all up-to-date. Plus, members can attend any of our power-up webinars for free. Our training covers Apple and Adobe software. We update it every week, and for more information, visit larryjordan.biz/subscriptions.